Hey friends, it's Shug Bury, and I am the host of HIM4Her Radio, Women's Hot Topics. Hey ladies, this is the best show that's out there. You know why? Because I am going across America in my RV, and I am down in Naples right now, and I am meeting the most interesting people. You all know that I have interviewed radio guests, international speakers, book authors, but I am meeting the most fabulous people on this trip that I decided to do an on-the-road segment, and I am here with wonderful Mark, thank you for joining us. And so Mark and I have had a chance to sit down and talk quite often, actually. And Leah, his beautiful wife, has introduced his story to me. And I wanted to bring it to you guys. You know, it's really a story of rising up, you know, despite what adversity is in the world. And Mark has got a story for us. He is pretty well known. He's actually, when you go to his different restaurants, et cetera, you'll be able to see all of the wonderful companies that they have, the businesses that they have. But I did first want to make sure that I read an excerpt just to whet your appetite a little bit of what he had written to Mr. Reeves, correct?
Christopher Reeves, yes.
Christopher Reeves. And it really spoke to my heart. So if you would bear with me just a minute, I'm going to read it.
Sure. And if you want me to give you a little background on that.
Would you?
Yeah. So I was driving home from one of my clubs. We had nightclubs at the time at 2 o'clock in the morning. And I was listening to the radio, and also the news came on, and they said that Christopher Reeves had this terrible accident. I went home, and it must have been 3 o'clock in the morning by that time. And I just jumped on my keyboard and I wrote a little thing that I thought was no big deal. And I still don't think it's a big deal, and sent it. And then, Reader's Digest published it, and then his wife reached out to me and asked if she could put it in her book. So mine and John Kennedy and a couple others were highlighted there, and it just, for some reason, it resonated very well with him.
You know what? It's just meaningful. So I'm just going to read a little bit of it. Dear Mr. Reeve, 6 years ago, the last thing I used my legs for was to hit my brakes. From the night my life changed so much, I didn't think I could do it. I received letters like this in the hospital and hated the people who tried to tell me everything was going to be okay. I was in the prime of my life, 29 years old. I owned 2 restaurants and had the best cars, a big house, and all the toys. And in the split second of all, that was useless. I went to therapy every day for a year and swore I would beat this. But every injury is different, and mine didn't turn out to be a success story. I cried and cried till one day I couldn't cry anymore, and I started to live with it. It's not easy. I still have some bad days, but I found out one thing that most people don't know. Listeners, I want you to listen up. I found how to be a whole person. Cars and money were not the important thing anymore. Just being a good person and taking each day the best I could made me happy. I have become an inspiration for so many people who can run and jump, and I am writing this letter to let you know that it's guys like you and me who have to keep our chins up to help not only those with disabilities, but even more so, people who are not disabled, so that they realize just how good they have it. There is a happy ending to my story, and we're going to share about that in just a minute, and we're going to share about his life, his restaurants, his family, so stay tuned, friends, but I want you to welcome Mark with me. Thank you, Mark, again for joining us.
My pleasure, Shug. It's a pleasure to be on your show. You're like a rock star in this.
Am I?
Or, yeah.
In the RV world?
No, I was thinking in the radio world for all women.
You know, we have had some really interesting guests on, and I love people's stories. That's what I love. I call them God appointments, Mark. You know, God brings us together. He gives us an opportunity to hear each other's stories. And I know that this is a story, you guys, of a guy who has risen above the adversity, the challenges, the difficulties, and he's going to share with us in detail about his story. So I really want you guys to stay tuned and to listen. Now, before we get that far, I want to share a little bit about the end of the story. Not that we're at the very end, but Mark, tell us a little bit about yourself, about your businesses, and about your family.
All right. Well, I'm very fortunate. I've got a wife, which we need to talk about, and how I finally got to come out into the public again. I kind of went in hiding after my accident, and my wife was key on that. But so I have a great wife. I got 2 children, 36, 34. I've got 4 grandkids, 2 3-year-olds, 1 6-month-year-old, and a 6-year-old.
Oh, you're blessed.
I'm so blessed. And the 2 boys were born 2 weeks apart, so they're like tag team wrestling.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
And you know what I love about you? You just, this is what your self-description was. You said that you are an adrenaline junkie.
Yeah, I like I like to really push the edge most of the time, just because, you know, since my accident, I thought, oh, so many people said, you can't do this, you can't do that. I can do whatever I want to do. It might take me a little longer sometimes, usually not, but if it does, I don't care. But I've conquered the biggest mountains in Aspen. I've been invited to ski the X Games. I water ski. I've got a trike I traveled all across America on. And I don't know if this is also on YouTube.
Yes,
so I'll do the moonwalk.
Okay, really quick, all
so
right.
You can see.
Check them out, people.
All right, there he goes. All right. So you can. I am in a wheelchair. Just if you didn't catch that.
So they know that. Yep. So that they're aware of that.
This is proof of life.
Yep, it is. And you know what I love about Mark is that he did not let this hold him down. Now, granted, this happened a long time ago. You were 29, right?
29 years old.
And tell us a little bit about that time. Did you, it was a car accident. Is that correct?
Yeah. Like I said, Shug, I was living the life of Riley. I had the most successful nightclubs you could possibly imagine. I think at one point I quit counting money and I started weighing it. It just got to the point where it came too fast, too much, too soon. And my background, my dad was a minister. So I was not used to that lifestyle. My mom was a hardworking immigrant. My dad was brought here as a missionary and 18 years, perfect attendance, this and that. And then I get thrown into this nightclub business by accident and was forced to deal with it. And everything that bad came along with it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm not going to lie, I indulged in, mm-hmm. and which ultimately wound up to making me a better person.
Mm-hmm. So you got in a car accident, correct?
Correct.
And then how long were you in the hospital for?
Well, I was in the hospital on and off for 2 years, actually.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, I was thrown from the car 150 feet and I wasn't really... I didn't break my back. The weird thing was I flew so far up in the air like Superman and then ended up falling straight down on my head. And it just made my spine condense so hard that one vertebrae popped in.
I'm so sorry.
Don't be sorry.
Yeah, I know, but it sounds so painful.
Yeah.
So, help me understand a little bit about the prognosis that they have given you.
So, I was when I finally woke up and to a room full of doctors, they were playing with my feet and playing with all parts of my body and saying, can you feel this? Can you feel that? And the doctor looked at me and he said, you're never going to walk again. And I was just so stunned, first of all, from the accident. But to hear that, it just too much. Too soon, I just couldn't comprehend it. Mm-hmm. So we started with, first of all, therapy. And first of all, we put me back together again, a lot of broken bones besides my back. And then I searched for the fix. And it took me to LA. It took me to Florida. It took me to Harvard Medical School. It took me all over the place with somebody promising or thinking they could fix me. And that's all I focused on. Mm-hmm. That was my focus. Not anything else, but I can remember going out to the yard sometimes and we have a hill and I jump off my chair and let the chair roll down the hill and I crawl and do whatever I could do to exercise and get those muscles working. I finally got to where I could walk with some leg braces and for maybe 100 feet. And I found that so unuseful. I'd fall all the time. I couldn't adapt that to work. So, I'd watch my wife take the kids and, I missed their, you know, their school plays. But
take your time.
Yeah. So I missed out a lot of life and, excuse me, one second.
No, that's okay. Take your time.
Finally, my wife would take the kids, and then she finally started going back to work, and she said, hey, we can't make a living like this. You can't ignore your business. You can't just sit at home and go to therapy. And she started strapping on these little mini skirts.
On herself or
on herself, not on me. And she'd say, stay home, go ahead, stay home. I don't care.
Yeah.
And she'd walk out. And I couldn't take it. I was like, I was so confused on what to do. And then one last night, I saw him going to the school play for the kids' Christmas play. And mm-hmm. I'm like, I can't do this anymore. I can't live in two worlds. So I took those leg braces, I threw them away. And I never, ever, ever thought about walking again. And that was the day that I started living.
Amen. 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 What role did God take in this process?
Well, we fought. We fought a lot. Mm-hmm. I couldn't understand it. He made me understand it. He knew I was not doing the right thing. He knew I wasn't a good person at the time. I had let success and I let the business I was in consume me. Mm-hmm. And the people I love the most is who I took it out on. And so he took me to the woodshed and he gave me my licking and he said, now you want to start living right. And if you do, you're going to have an unbelievable life. Mm. And I did. And from that day, God's been right there with me.
Amen. That's such a great testimony. How the Lord walks with us during difficult times, waits on us.
Oh yeah. He was walking with me. He was giving me a lesson. And the lesson that he didn't want me to do is, what ends up getting you in trouble the most, God will take from you. Mm-hmm. And I'm a firm believer in that. I know a lot of cases and I could go through one by one people that destroy themselves with their problems. And my problem is where my legs would take me and what I would do and how would I use them to be destructive to myself, my family, and everything else. So God just cut me off at the knees and said, you're done. Hmm.
Time to start looking up.
Yeah.
Yeah. Looking up at the Lord. And I want you to know too, ladies and gentlemen, from time to time, we might think that God causes this or he creates it, but oftentimes God allows it and he allows it to happen because he knows that he will be glorified in and through it, regardless of what happens in our lives. Sometimes life just happens and then we have to deal with it. And we know that God is with us all the time. But in this instance, you're really feeling it was a lesson from God to say, hey, look up at me. I'm going to be your legs for you and I'm going to help you fly.
Oh, absolutely. And a couple of things that, whenever I'd be going through this and I'd always repeat, yea, though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I fear no evil. Cause I wasn't scared, but I didn't know what the future held. But I knew I had some point to this whole nonsense and I couldn't figure it out. My dad used to tell me all the time, child of God, do not fear. So my dad was with me too. So it was,
Your dad, he loved the Jesus and he gave you a lot of good examples.
My dad was the best.
Was he alive when this happened?
No, no, mm-hmm. But he was with me.
Yeah. Yeah. You could feel his presence.
Oh yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's amazing. I'm so glad I got a chance to meet you. So I've got some questions that most people normally have who are not disabled or who doesn't, if you don't live with someone or you're not familiar with us. So bear with me as I get really elementary with this for a minute. Are you okay with it?
Sure.
So many people oftentimes don't know what to say or don't know how to act or, what's the appropriate thing? Is it rude to ask somebody what happened in their life? Or is it better to just wait for them to bring it up? What's the appropriate thing to do?
Shug, I really don't mind when somebody says, hey, what happened? I don't like a guy walking through a grocery store and looks at me and goes, what happened to you? I'd like to know who they are first, if I'm mm-hmm. telling them my story or whatever. But it's not bad at all. I think it's good. It's good to know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then what is appropriate term? Is it disabled? Is it handicapped? Is it, I don't know.
Again, I live in a world where I know I could do more with the handicap world. I try to do as good as I can, but 99% of the time I don't even know I'm handicapped. So I don't really want a tag like that.
Yeah.
I'm just like you or anybody else. I don't feel like you need to do anything special for mm-hmm. me. So I guess if you were going to use a word, I guess, I don't know. I don't, handicap.
You're disabled. Living in a wheelchair.
Yeah.
You're an adrenaline junkie.
I have no preference, and I really just assume that somebody just treats me like I'm anybody else.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know what? I believe people do. At least the people I've seen here, they really just embrace you and love you just the way you are. We all should.
Right. I think that's exactly why I love it here so much.
Yeah, I do. And you guys, just to remind you, we're RVing. And my name is Shug Bury, Him for Her Radio, Women's Hot Topics. And we are going across the road in our RV, and we are interviewing all the fascinating people that I'm meeting. I just absolutely love it. Mark is one of them as well. And we are down here at Pelican Lake Motor Coach Resort in our RV. And I have met so many amazing people, and Mark is definitely one of them. And so let me just jump back into the story again, if I can. How did this, you know, you had shared a little bit about how this impacted your family and your career direction, but you seem unstoppable, Mark. I mean, you really do. When I talk to you, you just seem like a guy who's unstoppable. And I know that there was a time that you were really battling with this, but what keeps you going? What keeps you persevering?
You know, again, I don't think that people know the blessings that they have every day. And how lucky they are. Like, I work with a lot of people. I'm in my restaurants or music venues or whatever. And to see somebody walk by a piece of paper and not pick it up on the floor, you know, God's given you all your faculties, everything. And for what people live through every day and not knowing how lucky they are, mm-hmm. and how fortunate they are that they can just walk up to a urinal and go to the bathroom or whatever they have to do. Mm-hmm. I think that I love life so much that I get up every day and I want another challenge and I want to do more and I want to make a bigger impact. And I just want to be, I want to live every day like it's my last.
Amen.
Yeah.
And what a legacy you're leaving for your kids and your grandkids.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's everybody's to follow. And my kids, I'm so lucky, are just right on my coattails, and they're trying to chase me down, and they're catching up right now.
Yeah, they're having trouble following you because you're always doing stuff.
They're doing really good. They're really, you know, again, blessings, right? A lot of very successful people or people that are just great people, you never know what happened to their kids or something went wrong. Mm-hmm. And I'm so blessed that's not part of my story. And if it was, I don't know what
Well, you're such a vibrant guy. I just sitting next to you, I just can feel your energy and just your excitement for life. And so I want to just change directions just for a minute, if I can. I was reading your history and your bio and what your life is like and everything that's going on in your life. And I just want to just take a left-hand turn here just for a minute and talk about, you went from really suffering with this and realizing, nope, I'm going to throw away my leg braces. I'm going to start to live life to the fullest. And then I read your bio and you have so many businesses that you're running and just the impact that you're making in Chicago area. I mean, you know, and can you just share a little bit? I mean, he's been nominated, and I could go on and on about this, but he's been nominated for having one of the best restaurants, venues, entertainment places in all of America for that matter. So would you share a little bit about what your life is like in Chicago?
Well, my life in Chicago, everybody knows about Chicago, right? We're starting at a disadvantage, but we don't let that stop us. We are so fortunate that we've got a great restaurant, music venue. We also work outside of our music venue. We do production if they need a leg of a tour picked up. We do major production outside of our business. But, you know, we've got this little town of 20,000 people. And I used to have multiple restaurants and I was going to pack it all in, get out of the business. I kept one of them. I said, let's make this a pet project. Let my kids see how to do this. And, you know, this little town that we live in, a 20,000 people.
And what's the name of the town?
Libertyville.
And what's the name of the business?
Austin Saloon and Eatery.
Austin Saloon and Eatery. I just love it. Okay. And so in Austin, you've also got this beautiful venue where people can come in, bands can come through. It's very well known. Tell us a little bit, if you would, just for a minute, about the Jenny O'Turkey. That's right. What happened there?
Well, Jenny O'Turkey came, my salesperson for that product came to me and they said, Mark, Jenny O's looking to find the best burger in America. Do you want to submit a recipe? I'm like, okay, I will. I'll cook something up and I'll write it down. And I'll let you know what it is. So I did that. And they said, Mark, you made it to the top 10. I was so surprised. And then it went 3 months between the top 10 people, and we ended up winning across the whole nation. And that's when one of the TV chefs came out and filmed the whole episode with us.
Wow.
And then we got printed on 5 million Jennie-O turkey labels on their ground beef package, and we're sold in grocery stores.
I absolutely love it. How American Burgers.
Yeah.
How America Burgers. Is that what it was titled? Yeah. And then on 5 million packages, I just absolutely, I watched it. You guys, you got to go online. You got to watch it. It's on YouTube. And you can see their wonderful restaurant. Can you tell us the name of the restaurant again?
Austin Saloon and Eatery in Libertyville, Illinois, austinsaloon.com. Or if you want to check out our venue, impactfuelroom.com.
I absolutely love that. Then tell us a little bit about Patio Life. You said that Patio Life is a new venture you're doing.
So we got into, we 3 years ago, I got very serious about trying. I added up the days that were rain days mm-hmm. in our business. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, okay, we've got about 62 rain days between May and November. Mm-hmm. And we got to figure out how to capitalize on that. So we took this pergola, which was a flat roof. And I kept saying, we can't put a hip roof on it. We can't do this. We can't do that. We have to come up with some really good technique or something high tech that mm-hmm. we can have the sun on some days or sun, no sun. Mm-hmm. So we put a louver roof on, and then we put shades on that can close up the whole exterior with just one touch of a button, either screens or 30 mil polymer plastic. The contractor who started the job screwed it up, ended up going, it went really, really bad. So I took it over, I finished it. And the manufacturers of the products called me and said, hey, we want you to, can we call on you to do this at other locations?
Yeah.
And that's when we got serious about it. So we created Patio Life 365, meaning we can make your patio useful 365 days a year.
Now you guys got to find this. It's patiolife365.com. And it's really cool. If you can see my hands, they showed the roof, and then they can open the roof, or they can withdraw the roof, or they have these screens that go up and down. I think we need some of that stuff here too.
It's really cool. The screens, I think, are going to be a big part someday mm-hmm. in this park. And yep.
So friends, if you want to reach out to me, info@himforher.org. I'm going to have all their logos on there. You can just click on there. You can go right to it. But Mark, I'm so thankful that you came on with me here today.
It's been a pleasure, Shug. You are an amazing woman. You talk about inspiration.
Yeah. We'll just keep pointing at each other, friends. Can we look good together? I hope you find us on YouTube. And again, my name is Shug Bury, Him for Her Radio, Women's Hot Topics. Please send us your topic ideas. And I am going to continue to interview people that I meet on the road. And friends, I want you to know the person you really need to meet is Jesus Christ, if you have not met him already, because I can tell you, he can be your strength, despite what your weaknesses might be. And Mark, you are a blessing and inspiration to all of us.
Well, Shug, you are, and I'm into what you just said, because you are keeping it alive.
Amen. Amen. Friends, you know I love you. Over and out.